He
said,
Hello and welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so that you notify each time I upload a video. You will be among the first to receive it. Thank you so much wherever you are connecting me from around the globe. I appreciate you. Please, each time you watch my video, go to the comment section and leave your comments. Comment according to what you have watched. You can make any contribution on the comment section. I read your comment from time to time and I learn a lot from the comment section. That is where we interact and say our mind. Whatever be your own opinion, put it down on the comment section. It doesn't matter, even if you are having a contrary opinion from those of us who are talking about the freedom of people, put it down in the comment section. We will listen to you and we will see what view you have. Thank you so much. And remember, today I come again to bring you information on things that are going on in the construction called Nigeria. As you all know, the construction called Nigeria has ended. There is nothing like Nigeria. Nigeria is a failed state. We are only mentioning the name Nigeria for people to know where we are talking about. When you talk about Nigeria being a country, Nigeria is no longer a country. It's a failed state. It's a failed state in all angle. Everything, every quality that a failed state has, Nigeria has it now. Nigeria has it. We are not just saying it. It has been proven on international standard. Many international bodies have named Nigeria as a failed state. And that is what Nigeria is. The insecurity is getting worse every day. It's getting worse. And it's not going to get better any soon. It's not going to get better any soon. That is why we are asking every well-meaning Nigerian, those who call themselves the one Nigerians, you begin to speak up. If you love your life, speak up and say the truth. And we are calling upon the Biafrans and Oduduans to continue to add their voice, continue to fight more than ever, speak more than ever, so that the world will hear our voice. Don't be silent. This is not the time to be silent. This is not the time to be scared. There's nothing to be scared of. Do not be scared of the Fulani Janjaweed. They are toothless barking dog. They can't do that. They have not conquered anybody. In case you don't know, the Fulanis have never conquered anybody in Nigeria except the Hausas, whom they treat. It wasn't even them that conquered the Hausa. The Hausa conquered themselves because they brought the message of religion to them and deceived them, and the Hausas killed their leaders. It was a deception. They didn't fight against the Hausas face to face to defeat the Hausas. They came with their trick and they overtook the Hausas. The Fulani have never conquered anybody, so there is no need to be afraid. They were not even able to penetrate to Tifis. The Tifis stood ground on them and defeated them and pushed them back. They couldn't defeat the Tifis. That was in the olden days, let alone in this generation where we have brains in the southern part of Nigeria, where the Tifis are more intelligent more than ever. Where are they going to come from? Where are they going to come from? They have lost the battle. That is why they are crying, shouting, and trying to hold on anything they can see. That is why they are destroying everything they can lay their hand upon in Nigeria, because they know it is all over for them. It is all over. The southern part of Nigeria is going home. The middle belt are going. It is before that they have deceived the country, trying to talk about, when they talk about the north, they include even the middle belt. They include the middle belt into the north, deceiving people. But today, the middle belt have woken up. They are no longer part of the north. They are standing on their own. And the southerners are going on their ways. That is the way we defeat them. They have no stronghold. For anybody trying to put fear in you, these people are cowards. That is why even where they go to attack, they never attack in the daytime. They always come at night. They abduct people at night and go and kill them. They don't come face to face to fight. These are a bunch of cowards. And the south will stand down with them and finish them up. This is why they are so scared about Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. They know that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu has all the strategies in place. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu knows them better than they know themselves. And Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is not relenting. He's not looking at their faces. He doesn't care about what they say. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is fighting against the terrorists, the Fulani terrorists and their cabals. He stood toe-to-toe to them. That is why they are so scared. They are so scared of him. And when they abducted him, they are all happy. Abducting Mazi Nnamdi Kanu cannot end it. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have put everything in place. And everything that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have put in place is still working perfectly well. Don't think that the ESN have been defeated. ESN are even more stronger. There are more recruitment in ESN today more than ever. More people are being recruited into ESN more than you know before. ESN have more formidable force more than ever. And for those of us there, we have to continue to support ESN. Do not relent in your support. Don't think that because maybe Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is being held captive that ESN is not. ESN is now working much more than ever. If you have been supporting ESN with a little, increase your support to ESN, because they are having a lot of job to do now and they are working. More people are being recruited into ESN. If you do not know that, know it from now. We have to all wake up, continue to do the right thing, and more especially the media. The media in that contraption called Nigeria, they are very devilish and very senseless. Very devilish. That is why when Mazi Nnamdi Kanu talks about the media, call them out. You think he's talking about a tribe. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is not attacking the Yoruba people. He's attacking those of them who are in charge of the media. Because these people are devilish. Even when their son, Igbowo, was attacked, the media, we are changing the narrative. They were changing narrative against Igbowo instead of saying the truth, how things happen. Igbowo, who never killed anybody, never committed any atrocity, you declare him wanted. They said Igbowo is on hiding. The only thing you will see on their media is that Igbowo has gone on hiding. Igbowo has gone on hiding. And the media will hype the information everywhere. That is the evil media we have. And today, the Janjaweed are using this media to fight against every indigenous person in that very country from called Nigeria. You see the new propaganda they are pushing. They said that the ESN and the Nigerian government and the Nigerian army clashed in Ebonyi State. This is the Ebonyi on Enugu, and two military men were killed. Another propaganda. They are now looking for a source or something to nail on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. They are trying to look for an evidence to use against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, when it is obvious they have no evidence from anywhere. And their media is pushing this narrative that the ESN fought with the military, they clashed with the military, and two military men were killed. Tell me where the media went to see that. Who told the media that the people who fought the military were ESN? Where did they get the evidence from? If not from their police and their army. There is no objective journalism in Nigeria. There is no investigative journalism in Nigeria. They cannot investigate it on their own and give us facts. The only thing you hear from Nigerian conventional media is police said this, police said that, military said that, government said this, and government said that. They cannot do their own investigative journalism and bring out fact. Never. Every accusation they are making on IPOB, on ESN, they have never ever done their own underground investigation to come and tell us, look at what happened. They said ESN are unknown gunmen, trying to frame ESN with unknown gunmen. Have you ever met with unknown gunmen and talked to them and asked them on their own? The only people they are bringing, the people who the government have captured by themselves and used to frame ESN. The cultists whom the government captured and gave them a deal to claim to be ESN. You see some of the testimonies, most of them, some of them, when they tell you when they joined ESN, even then ESN has not been formed. The information they are passing there on their confession is all false. This is what the media is pushing. They are using the media against the masses, and the media is supporting them. Nigerian media. No investigative journalism. When you know that journalists can go, unknown gunmen are not hidden. Even when they go operation, people talk to them. Why can't the media disguise and go to them and talk to them and let them tell you whom they are and where they are coming from? Such had not been had. The only thing we hear is police caught them, they made a confession. Military caught them, they made a confession. What confession do you expect to get from somebody who has been tortured and forced to say something that he did not do? You and I know the system of Nigerian government and their military. This has always been their propaganda. And now they are pushing a new propaganda that ESN killed two military men when they had a clash in the police state. How did you know it was ESN? How did you know? This is just the propaganda they are carrying around. Just how did you know? Did you go and interview ESN in the war front? Did you go and interview an innocent ESN on their own, without somebody interrupting, on their own, telling you what they do and what they don't do? Have you ever been able to do such investigation? Have you ever been to do that? All they are peddling is lies. Trying to look for something to nail Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, but Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is far, far ahead of them. They have no case against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and we never have any case against him. They have no case against him. Whatever. When Mazi Nnamdi Kanu formed the vigilante, he said it openly that the ESN are fighting against the terrorists. He did not form the ESN to fight against the military. He did not form the ESN to fight against innocent people. He didn't form the ESN to fight against police. He formed the ESN to fight against the terrorists in the bush who are coming to occupy the land, whom the government told us that they are foreigners. Those bandits, the government said they are foreigners, and the government told us to go and defend ourselves. It is the government that said this. They tell us to go and defend ourselves. And Mazi Nnamdi Kanu formed a security to defend the eastern part, southeastern part of Nigeria. And now they are trying to look for all their propaganda and lies. Their lies will never save them. Chukwuka Abiam is ahead of them, and he has given Mazi Nnamdi Kanu wisdom to do everything the way it's supposed to be. We'll continue to praise him. We'll continue to worship him. We'll continue to support him. We'll continue to pray for Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. We'll continue to pray for him wherever he is. We'll continue to stand with him. It doesn't matter what they say. It doesn't matter what they do. Let us enjoy the job of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Let us show our appreciation to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and his lawyer for what they are doing for the Biafrans. Through this video I'm going to play, let us watch the video carefully. It's an Igbo video. If you don't understand Igbo, you might not be able to understand it. I'm really sorry for that. Maybe you will get an interpreter. But for those of us who understand Igbo, watch this video carefully. Let us use it to celebrate Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and his lawyer. Let's watch.
Ijelo ke bi ko ke mmanwu abu ni ata no nyanwa ni na eche pa ni na ye kuchigo
After watching this video, you can agree with me that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu deserves all the praises, he deserves all the love, he deserves all the care, and we will continue to do that. No matter what the media do, no matter their propaganda they are pushing there, we will not allow them. We will always make the truth to come forward. Recently, they also went to begin to change the narrative on the attack that happened at Ladebo Market, where the innocent businessmen who were doing business, the Biafrans who were doing their business, military went there and shot in the market and killed people. The media jumped into it and began to change the narrative, begin to talk about clash. Clash, clash. How do you clash with a military man with well armed? How do you clash with a military man with the air with other hand? You are talking about clash with empty hand. They are raising the propaganda of clash, clash, clash. But we will never allow them to sell that story. I'm going to share with you the true situation of what happened in Ladebo. Watch it from beginning to end. You will enjoy the story and know exactly what happened in Ladebo, not what they are peddling in their conventional media. Watch.
Chairman, what is happening here, market? I says, I don't know. In fact, because of that, I'm heading to Ibero. I took Okada. When I got to Zenith Bank, it was like a war zone. People were running helter-skelter. Where they are running this way, I was coming this way. They said, Chairman, where are you heading to? This thing is happening here, unit. I said, it doesn't matter. My people are there. Let us all go there and die together. If you hear the sound of God, you say, what is happening? When I got there, before I got to this roundabout, I met DPO, police post, DPO Solo, Alonso, and one man we call Bakasi, SP. We jumped there, all of us begin to proceed to the market. Along the line, we met President, and they jumped together. Because of curiosity, I have to rush down to my market to know the extent of damage, because I've heard that more than 2-3 people have dropped with bullet shots. When I got there, the majority of them had been taken to hospital. I could not see any of them. I addressed my marketers. After addressing them, I had a call that the people that shot them has been apprehended somewhere in Toyota through the help of an Afric, the Army Resettlement Center here. They said we should come down to that center. As I was going, I met Mr. President also going to that direction. We met at Toyota. And what I'm telling you, my own side of the story, the way I see it. When I got to Toyota, all of us, they begin to ask us questions. They were trying to compromise what happened. We are talking about human life, and you are telling me that my people attack Army. Attack Army with what type of people? We are bloody civilians. We deal on motor pass. How do we attack you? We are talking about somebody that left his home this morning by 8 o'clock, only to come down here by 10 o'clock he's dead. If he's your brother, if he's your husband, what will you tell us? What are we talking about here? When I look up, I saw inside their vehicle, they're still holding two of our men hostage. I said, for what? I ran mad. I said, why must you? Okay, after killing, you want to take some of us back? Is this place Sabisa Forest? What is going on in Nadebo? Nearly 3-4 days ago, we experienced serious fire disaster that claimed billions of naira. Today, we are talking about lives being lost. Where are we heading to? Where are people's eyes? You attack us. Why? That was when they begin to suffer better. So another guy came from Air Force. I got S command, somewhere in Ikeja. He now demanded that I should come with Mr. President to his office. It's okay. We joined them in their vehicle. We went there. And getting there, we saw a few of our people. He requested we come to his private office, which we did. On getting there, we drop our phones, normal protocols. Then we begin to talk. I discovered that he's taking side. Was telling me their people are trained people. They don't attack people. Maybe our boys are funny. That was why they now begin to release bullets. Something must have persuaded them. And he's telling me that instead of any of the boys to lose their gun or anything funny, that they are permitted to shoot. I say, you are permitted to shoot and shoot animals? Are you shooting fowls? You have just said so. Then I'm the chairman of that market. I will tell you that you can even shoot me here in your office. My people blood cannot go that way. We must get to the root of this issue. At a point, Mr. President, sir, I told him, you are taking this personal. You are taking it personal. I'm not more comfortable with the way you are going about this issue. Let us invite independent people to come and investigate this matter. And let us get the truth. You interviewed their men. I was here. President was there. You interviewed their men. In your own way. We saw all the blunders they committed. And you are telling me that they are right. We are not judged in this matter. Judges will come into this matter. And he took a lot of our time, because I know he also had distress calls from different quarters. When he came in, I said, President, our folks that are not here is not comfortable by us. We should remember, we are leaders of this market. People may be trying to get across to us. And there's nothing more or less than that. People want to get across to us. Even our families might be panicking if we are dead. Or where even the people we kept to that barrage street don't even know our whereabouts. President, let us go and leave this place. I'm not more comfortable here. When he came, we voice out immediately. Now we are not comfortable not to leave. He said very soon, I'm not okay. Immediately he comes in, we now of us start to sit up that we are leaving. We went and collected one. When I came, I saw more than close to 40 missed calls. Same thing we said, including him. Actually, he used that vehicle to bring us back here. But you know what pissed me off? This morning, we wake up with different type of funny news. Majority for Ladebo. Few of them that have gotten one experience or the other against Ladebo. Where do you get your reports? We don't know. Because first, I know very, very well that this thing happened in my unit. We have not interviewed anybody from my unit. Neither have you spoken with anybody from LASEC. So where is the report coming from? That was why I deemed it necessary for us to convey this type of gathering, so that who will tell the press, who will tell the world exactly what is going on. But I want us to know that we're talking about act of terrorism. This is a terrorist. They are terrorists. Because they came here with Fulani people. They were speaking Hausa. They are going to waste our lives. It's still becoming. I will stop here, so that I'll give chance to other people. But meanwhile, I have one or two persons that is from my unit that was there, eyewitness of detailed information of all that happened yesterday. I came here with one of them. I was going to talk with you so that you know exactly. I know very well that money collecting from gate is not a problem. Nobody asks them for money. When our army people come, we don't collect money from army, police, and navy. All the three armed forces, we don't collect money from them. It is our law. Even the vehicles, we don't collect money. We never collected one naira from anybody. This was a transaction that was did about January this year. Kickstarter that is not more than 3,000-4,000
naira. So, sir, make it easy for us. Tell us what happened. If you want to talk about Kickstarter, we don't even know anything about Kickstarter. So tell us like we don't know. Exactly. Like we don't know. Good. Like we don't know.
We, like you rightly said, we hear from the horse's mouth. Yes. Now, what we had was that it was a toll issue that they wanted to collect money from the operatives that came into the market to buy goods. Now, what you are telling us now, it happens last year. Now, what you tell us now is just tell us how it happens. From last year, we see what happens yesterday. Now, and the issue of the startup, we don't know what startup is. Tell us everything we know about this issue.
Thank you very much. What I'll tell you is indirect speech, but that I'm not an eyewitness, but as a chairman, I will speak what I hear and what I know.
I'm sorry,
sir, who would prefer an eyewitness?
Is Uchenna around?
Yes, Uchenna.
Uchenna, the man that dealt the army guy, the customer, because I was on ground yesterday, and my report, I had key staffer because I was told that. So, but who is Uchenna around? Uchenna would be the best person to tell us. Uchenna, known as Chisco, is he around?
Sorry, Solomon, who is Uchenna or Chisco? That's nothing like that. That's nothing like that.
What
is
trying to say that if there's an eyewitness,
I said yes. Please come over this way. Yes. No, he speaks very well.
Okay.
I'm okay.
Your name?
My name's Mr. Ajuchu Esanya.
Go ahead, sir.
So yesterday, the time is 11:45, to be precise. Understand what I mean? So, I came to first office to charge food. Then I met with the BCC. They were talking to one soldier. The man was wearing jean and camouflage, long sleeve, and putting sweater. He was discussing about the 40 he brought the other day with that. Little time, I was there. When one guy came in, he was wearing white shorts and long sleeve. He came, please, excuse me, sir, I have a complaint. I said, okay, wait. So when I finish with him, then I can attend to you. So he said, no, I'm talking to you, then you're discussing with another person in front of that soldier. So that soldier looked at him and kept quiet. I was still talking with the PCC chairman. I mean, public complaint committee chairman. So they are discussing on the said, can't you hear me? There's altercation there. Two of them started saying, you bloody simply, I'm talking to you. Why is he moved? Everybody look, that's what it meant. You don't understand him. He said, please, can you go outside? He went outside, we were just shouting. Little Titan, I'm going to show you who I am. And he came with one guy that's wearing bag at his back, a civilian. So when they are going out, then one Mr. Solomon rushed to him, said, please calm down, what's your problem? That's where the man opened up and said, the father of this guy here sent me to help him retrieve some goods there, Kickstarter. That's why he called his friend. The guy was telling him, leave him there. Then two of them went. Then I went back to the office and asked this chairman, what is the problem between you and that man that left? He said, this is exactly. Even the army man that was attending to testified to me. He said they are coming back. So I'm not going to go anywhere. As an editor, I stay over in the market. Let me stay nearby and watch events. Where we're going to come back again to tell the situation. Within 10 minutes, he lost his speech. said no. Money came every place just we are under search. Totally. The other guy was you bloody Biafran or what? I don't believe in fucking sentiments, but I know they are useless bizarres. I want to get this in shreds. Someone telling you it's toast is rubbish. There's nothing like that because you come to complain. We never even know the reason why you come to the markets. This has been the order of the day. A mechanic will come, I hire army outside. How much I'm going to pay? Somebody will be outside. As a Major General Yakubu from Abuja. If you don't change the engine, I close the market. This threat is too much for us to bear on a daily basis. Then I want to ascertain what prompts you to come with this guy. We have not discussed to know that if you have not satisfied you. Immediately, I was just begging them. They brought gun and start shooting. I beg. I hold the guy. Please, the casualty will be much. People are too much. This is why people are start running and defending themselves and throwing stones. When you are throwing stone, I'm the only person in the buffer zone between the army, Air Force guys, and the traders. The only person, everybody run. Whenever they run, I just kneeling down, please go back. When this guy wants to, the driver was having gun by his side. Then he shoots. The guy, the most red shorts and white shirts, go and grab the gun. I will tell you who shoots who. The guy that died here, I know the person that shot him dead. The guy that shot inside, I know the person that shot him dead. So the guy kneeled down, so there's nothing like straight bullets. He's aiming at, then he knelt down. Very wise. By the side, if you're entering this gate now, I shot that guy at the stomach, one the buttocks, one the leg. The guy, they carried him up. So when I was helping the soldier, because I wanted to leave the market, immediately, I entered, that's their helos. I helped them to jack it up. Then I brought out the rim that was holding the vehicle. So the guy was revising. Then I brought out the front chair that it was in the front. He was really so rough when they are coming out. I run outside Tunumbu block and they carried that guy that shot. When I was running, the same young guy, he's a Fulani guy or Yamsa guy, he just ran again when I was carrying that guy to the all the Tanzanian people deserted me. Blood was all over my body. He said, drop that idiot, let me just finish him there. Then he pointed gun at me, direct in my heart. Just like this, that if I move or say anything, that's enough of me. He was going to waste me here and nothing will happen. I said, my son, look at me. Even my last born. I went to NTA 83. I was dropped. By then, your mother had not been born before. Don't take anybody see here from granted. He said, if I said anything, I said, going to shoot me for anything. Then the guy, is the person that collected that rifle from the one wearing white and shot this man here. It's when he finished with me, coming back, then he shot that guy that died. Yeah, immediately. Then he went to the market. By that time, people have run inside their shops. What they did, they go out and mobilize and carry sticks. I hit people's heads, breaking people's heads. I was shouting. I called that yellow one. Say, I begged you. I knelt down and begged you. Please, casualty, leave this market. This is mountain of 3005. Your cost life, man. What you people want? Now, I was so astonished this morning when I read some trash and stupid thing somebody can put up. What are you talking about life?
So let's be careful of the words. Now, about the people that were shot and the people that died, how many were shot? How many died?
Good and fine. We are not praying for more casualties or more people to die. There are some people that are in the hospital. They are going to that place to ascertain their condition. Some people are still in coma.
How many?
I don't know, won't know how many.
We are coming. I was coming with them from Lagos. We saw Terry. He was dead Terry in the hospital.
Sorry, dead?
No, alive.
Three are alive.
He bled to severe wounds. One of them is just coming out from theater. Major operation. Yes. And yesterday evening, while we came back from Ikeja, they brought one corpse here in Lademo. That one wanted to trigger another casualties. But the president went and questioned, you know, addressed our boys, all of them left. So that is the one. I don't know if there's any casualty at Solo General Hospital. that we are not yet
sure.
That
was one that died.
Okay.
So, Mr. President,
in total, how many people died?
What died? The one. I don't
know. One. Yes.
Yes.
So the market has confirmed.
Sorry. Okay, Mr. President.
My name is Daniel. As at 8 p.m. years ago, investigation revealed that two cops were dropped at the army barracks in Africa. How true is this?
Yeah, you said you are who?
My name is Guardian. Guardian.
As at 8 p.m. yesterday, investigation revealed that two dead bodies were dropped out.
It was your first information.
Have you confirmed that? That's why we are here. Our own is to confirm. So these are your people. And you mentioned that one person so far, one day,
the president was random. Yeah. My name is Obi Oraume. I'm a legal practitioner, right to the association. I'll start by saying that what happened yesterday is not the beginning of the intimidations, the harassments from the military in the market. I recall 2 years ago, I came to the market and there were two army men. They came in uniform. And one of them said that he bought an engine he used for 8 months. And that the engine had started smoking, that he wanted a replacement. And that because the person who sold the engine refused to replace it for him, he wanted to arrest him and take him to the barracks by force. Fortunately, I was around. I said you were not going to take him anywhere. Because number one, what you bought was not a brand new engine. You bought a fairly used engine. And normally, if you have used engine for 8 months and it starts smoking, then it's either you buy another one or go and
repair it.
You can't come because you are an army officer and beat this guy, take him to the barracks. So that day the chairman was around some other executives and then we insisted. It took several hours. Finally, they left and then subsequently they came back in larger number. But at the end of the day, some senior officers in the military got to know about it and the matter was resolved. That was not all. There was another incident. So this thing has been recurring over time. And then what we then decided was that the association decided to put up a very big signboard, visible to everybody. If you go outside there, you'll see it. And what is contained in it is a public notice. A public notice is a notice to the whole world that whatever you bought as fairly used, that there is no guarantee that you are going to return it after some time. Before you take it away, it must be tested. And once it's tested and it's working, you go with it, you take it, and that is the way it is. So now, coming to what happened yesterday. Yesterday, there was a matter that concerned the association I was in court. It was after the court, I was told that no single person came from the association. I now called the chairman. He told me that there was an incident that the army came and opened fire. I said, how did it happen? That was when I knew that because of Kickstarter that one army man bought about 6-7 months ago, suddenly the thing stopped working. He now came to the market to insist, as they usually do, for a replacement. And at the end of the day, matter was resolved. Then after it was resolved, between him and the, I was still not fully satisfied. He now went to the task force office. At the task force office, you have the PC chairman, public complaint committee chairman, Mr. Omunna Obi. And he was really attending to some people. So they told him to hold on. He was not ready to wait. And in that case, I need to remind you that he did not come in any army uniform. There were two of them. became a mufti. And he felt that because he's an officer, even though there are nothing on the face of it apparently to show that this man is an officer, that he must be attended to first. So they pleaded with him, please, be patient. He refused. So one of them now told him, Oga, please, can you give us chance? He took offense. He went and they came back with open messer and wanted to finish the traders. Because, number one, if you are firing arms, you are shooting gun, not up, but aiming at people, what you tend to do is to kill. And the law says that you bear the consequences of your actions. So somebody that is aiming at people and shooting indiscriminately wanted to kill. The question is, why do they want to kill? Kill innocent unarmed civilians. Why? Was there, because there was there any threat? Well, there was no threat. Was there, they can we even say in the in widest imagination that was they were shooting as a result of defense, self-defense, nothing like that. At the time the two of them left the market, there was no problem. Only to go back and unleash mayhem on the traders. Now, it is enough. We are not going to allow this matter to lie low. For now, nobody can say precisely the number of people that have died.
Sure.
Because we don't know. The market is such a big place that when the shooting started, people were running helter-skelter. And the market has been shut down by the association, at least to get to the root of this matter. So it's at the end of the day we find out how many people actually died. But at least we know that yesterday, some people brought cups of one young man aged about 28 years that died. We are hearing that some other people may have died. We don't know. But the issue is that at the end of the day, we're going to send a petition to the Inspector of Police on this matter. We're also going to send one to the Chief of Army Staff on this matter. We're equally going to send one to the Governor of the State and the Commissioner for Police on this matter. Let the whole world know that it is wrong for somebody, because you are an army man, you are army, you are paid from the tax paid by the civilians, the masses, the gun you have is not your personal gun, you are using it to kill people in something that has to do with contracts. Because buying and selling is contractual. It's purely contractual. Not so that is the problem that is at hand. It has been on for, but this is the time that a life has been lost. And we see it as murder.
Okay,
it's murder.
Let's hear from the president so that we can wrap up this issue.
They are men of the Air Force, not Army. Let's not mistake
Air Force personnel.
Air Force.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said before, my name is Mr. Chikamombo.
Sorry,
the general is not permanent. It's quite unfortunate. The incident that happened yesterday in Lagos Market. We have been facing a series of problems with soldiers. And I believe this is the time we are going to stop it. I believe by the grace of God, time will come when we decide in Lagos Market not to sell any motor spare parts to any soldier. It's getting out of hand, taking laws into their hands, and we're here talking about Kickstarter, worth of how much? 3,500. And somebody is dead, which you don't know how many people that died. So many are still in the hospital. We are going to take this matter to the highest authority to make sure we get judgment. Thank you very much.
So since yesterday, have you heard from the Atlanta, you went with the army? Have you heard from them? There been any conversation, any exchange between you and the army?
Yesterday, we went to their office. You know, as a soldier, they are trying to protect their boys. But which we told them that we are leaving their office to go and make report to the necessary place that we're supposed to do. As of that yesterday, we air our own view to them. It's quite unfortunate that soldiers will come inside the market and started shooting traders direct, as if they are animals. The intimidation in their office was so much to us, and we left. That's all. But this morning, one of their commander called me that he would like to have a meeting with our executives. But due to the situation of the market today, we decided to shut down to show the world, to show the Nigerians what happened in Ladipo market, to solidarity with the person that died. That's the reason why our market was shut down today. That's the reason why we will not be able to have time to go and meet the Air Force commander. Thank you.
I don't know if you are demanding for any damage. Are you making a demand?
As of now, not yet. We are demanding for justice.
How many days will the market be?
I cannot say anything for now.
Okay. We know, let's put this in another context. Aleppo is a big market with high economic value. Between yesterday that this incident happened and our situation in the market, can you get a bit some figure what the market or the general looks like?
Thank you very much, my brother. Like the question you just asked me, Ladipo market is the biggest of a mobile market in the whole West Africa, not in Nigeria. But as of now, we are not talking about how much we lost.
We're talking about life.
Talking about
life. Second question, sir. Also, our preliminary investigation is following what the learned person here said, being issues between the military, if you come to market to buy goods, and also give the money to our chairman, even after the goods. Let me use myself being very important to the market. Now, between the person, because I know that if you buy some, whether it is poor or new money, sometimes it may be to have a leverage, some dealers. Traders give guarantee to what they buy. The guarantee. There is some guarantee and guarantee.
Yes.
And then, now, because there, at any point where that dealer had this agreement, because he said that business or trading is a contractual agreement. I'm throwing your word now.
Yes.
That is a contractual agreement. Was there any relationship, that contractual agreement between them, that if it gets spoiled, you can return this, and what was the period? If the person here can tell us, so that we put things in perspective, that is one. Two, there have been also incidences where even the computers of companies is usually uncalled for. And sometimes when they come to market, they are being awful and all of that. Now, this issue, investigation revealed that when you went to the PCC office and you tried to make logical that one of the best task force, we were not there, but our underground investigation gave us this. how the school. And it was when it was now, he had to call, then he put it all across to his school. And they reinforced and came back. That was when they came, also investigation in that they were chased or they were pelted with bottles. And in the process, one of the bottles was and he one of the soldiers that he did. And there was blood spilled. On that process, he saw the blood, he was aggrieved or angered.
Thank you very much for your question. The Ipob market is a very big market. We have like 46 units chairmen, which the incident that happened yesterday was at Akoyi Uruwansi market. So the chairman of Akoyi Uruwansi market is here to answer that question.
Thank you. Your first question. In our notice board, we gave warranty of 1 week. When you buy, under 1 week, we gave you warranty. There are differences between guarantee and warranty. Bring it, we'll take care of it. We'll make sure that it works. That is warranty. I cannot give you guarantee because I'm not the producer. So, we give 1 week warranty. And once it is 1 week, you bring it back. You find it difficult to collect your money. That is where it looks as if you are hostile. Where we buy, we don't have any parameter. We used to know if that engine or that item is okay or not. We incur a lot of loss with ourselves this engine to the end user. We, the executives here, we have our own vehicles. We also experience what we people are experiencing. I can buy an item and it doesn't work. I bring it to you. He said, chairman, do I go now after you come? When I go there once, twice, when I feel bored, maybe now you go later bring my money back to me or you give me exactly what I want. This is to combo business we are doing. Fairly used. What the problem before this, we both said and give us, what the problem is, we don't know. The second question, remind me what you asked. He said,
they slapped the man.
I think I also have an eyewitness, as I told you, because if I give you the information, it will look as if maybe I'm trying to jump God. Please, Mr. Dokum, did anybody slap anybody that yesterday?
That man is so rude. To the constituent authority or public opinion committee was shouting. And had it been, I know the number of that soldier they are attending to. And I called him, he was there. There was a certain thing that place they intervened to ascertain his problem why he was in the market. When this guy is suddenly walking, I was interrupting that he must be attended first. So please leave my office. Nobody shuts your office. I know you're living here. What I know, this is not Korean call. Nigerian soldiers that know the rules of investment. Maybe the president broken around that was shipped to
South. So let me help you once again. Sorry, let me portray this point very clear. Here in our market, we have PCC. That's the first port of entry. You establish against it. After the judgment, if you're not comfortable, we have appeal. Go and put for appeal. If you're not comfortable, you have the office of the executive chairman. Come there, bring your matter, it will be resolved. But I'll tell you all here that any case that comes to my office personally must be attended to, and justice must prevail. I also have confidence, even the members of my PCC, they'll be doing a very wonderful job. If they are not competent enough, I would have been having some shaking mind. But I know, I trust to some large extent that they are doing good. Thank you.
Okay, that should be all from the press conference from the traders of
Ipob
Market, where they bring the stress about what can happen and what is good for you. They say then go follow up, try to look into how to get justice for their people, and for now they don't seal the Ladipo market as a result. I won't come from this place, I will brief one more before I go leave this place completely.
Bro, I didn't spread on my.
So I finished listening to the traders of the market, and we're pulling out of the place where they do their press conference. I won't stay outside. Show now an aerial view of Ladipo market. According to the president, Mr. Wang Kuo, he talks say the Ladipo market now the biggest spare parts market in the whole West Africa. And now they don't shut them down because of this incident that happened. They on their own shut them down in order to try to commiserate with the families of people who lose person that yesterday, to identify with them and to protest what didn't happen. I won't show now the area view. According to the chairman, the whole of Ladipo market is going to be shut down at least for today to protest what happened yesterday. As you can see, many of the sellers there around. This is not the largest spare parts market in the whole of West Africa, not just in Nigeria, and where this particular incident happened. The gates of the market, they completely shut as we speak. Let me zoom into the gate so that you confirm. What can I tell you? So this one, one of the gates of the market, and as you can see, is sealed. There is another one too. This one too, another gate there, and it's also sealed. So they have so many units in the big Ladipo market, and all these units don't shut down for now to protest what happened yesterday. See this one too, this whole building, this yellow building. So now also another part of the market, and also that one too don't shut down. So this is the situation for Ladipo market. We don't confirm from the authorities for Lagos State University Teaching Hospital, say they bring in at least 3 people with gunshot wounds yesterday, and they don't stabilize those 3. That is to confirm, say true shooting happened around here, and about 3 people were injured, and 1 person differently don't die from the situation. That's the situation we don't get from this area. And with the hell of an hour day with us since we begin this broadcast, I will continue today bring on more information as time unfolds. With the hell of now, bye.
After seeing all this, are you now convinced that we are on the right path? Continue to be happy, you have the right man by your side. Chukwuka Biambo will continue to bless Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Chukwuka Biambo will continue to strengthen Mazi Nnamdi Kanu wherever he is. Chukwuka Biambo will continue to fight for us, everyone that is fighting for freedom, including our Odudua brothers. Chukwuka Biambo will guide and protect all of us. Thank you for watching wherever you are watching from. And remember this. Bye-bye. See you again on the next video. Thank you.